Director of Bands here at Itawamba Community College, and I'd like to welcome you to the 2023 ICC Spring Band Concert. We appreciate your attendance at this evening's concert and hope that you enjoy what you're here tonight. We would like to ask at this time if you would silence your cell phones, as this concert is being recorded and these students have put in lots of hours of preparation for this performance. We will begin this evening's concert with the ICC Symphonic Band. Would you please help me welcome to the stage the ICC Symphonic Band under the direction of Ms. Christy Coleman and Mr. Eric Simmons.
Once again, thank you for being here tonight. We appreciate you being here to support your children, your family members, the music department at ICC, and the fine arts in our community. The encouragement and dedication you have provided throughout their band experience have given them an opportunity to help fund the start of their higher education, make lifelong connections with others who share their passion, and help instill an element of grit in their character. Music matters, your support matters, and we are grateful. We begin tonight's performance with a trip around the world where we will experience a sampling of music that represents a variety of cultures. From our neighbors across the pond to the southern regions of Latin America, I'm sure you will find something that tickles your fancy. I would now like to welcome Mr. ICC, Tykes Daniels, to introduce the first selection.
Good evening. My name is Tykes Daniels, and I'm from Starkville, Mississippi. I'm a communication major here on the Fulton campus. 3 Hours of Gloucester was inspired by a fascination with an old 10th century English couplet, "There's no one quite so calmly as the jolly Earl of Cholmondeley." The resulting 3 movements, the Jolly Earl of Cholmondeley, Ayer of Eventide, and the Fiefs of Wembley, are composed in an early English folk song style. They are designed to capture the mood of the peasants and their life on the fiefs of Wembley Castle in southwest England. Would you please welcome Mr. Eric Simmons to the stage?
honors two well-known 19th century spirituals, Wayfaring Stranger and Going Home, that both allude to going home to meet deceased family members in a place with no sickness or suffering, the afterlife. The peaceful music depicts this hopeful view of heaven and a sense of homesickness. Also known as Poor Wayfaring Stranger or I Am a Poor Wayfaring Stranger, you'll hear this well-known American folk and gospel song about a plaintive soul on a journey through the life. The lyrics were published in 1858 and speak to the human spirit's trying times on the verge of death. The tune is part Christian hymn, prayer, woeful song, and an ode to every man's journey. The words for the second beautiful song, Going Home, are based on Anton Dvorak's famous Largo from his Symphony No. 9, From the New World. Opus 95, this symphony was composed while he was in America and it was first performed by the New York Philharmonic at Carnegie Hall on December 16, 1893. W.A. Fisher described his song as a moving expression of the nostalgia of the soul all human beings feel. Anthony Susi's arrangement of Home Awaits features a sensitive piano accompaniment beautifully performed tonight by ICC's piano professor, Mrs. Anna Cheryl. This gentle and pensive nature of this warm setting will evoke feelings of peace and hope. Would you please help welcome Ms. Christy Colburn back to the stage for Home Awaits. ICC, and my major is sports medicine. So this next song, it's the Zia Pueblo, situated atop of a salt mesa in north-central New Mexico. It compromised Ayers and speaking Indians who have continuously occupied the site since the 13th century. The sun symbol has a sacred meaning to the Native American Zia Pueblo Indians. The design reflects their tribal philosophy that all things in the universe share a common harmony. The four directions of the symbol are of the great significance to Zia as they believe man has four sacred obligations: a strong body, a clear mind, a pure spirit, and a deep regard for the welfare of others. Four is a sacred number that symbolizes the circle of life, four winds, four seasons, four direction, and as mentioned, four sacred obligations. The circle binds the four elements together. In 1925, New Mexico adopted the Zia symbol as the official insignia of the state flag. The central location of the Zia caused them a lot of problems. Navajo and Apache raiders were a constant threat. The Spanish first came in 1541 and interfered in the spiritual ways of the Zia. The Zia joined the Pueblo Revolt in 1680, but the Spanish returned 8 years later to destroy much of the Zia community. In 1692, the Zias accepted mass baptism and became Roman Catholics. However, this did not stop the traditional religious practices of the Zia. The Zia were successful dry land farmers and could sustain large populations. They grew corn, beans, squash, and melons. The Zia imported irrigation technology to help make the farmlands more productive. The Spanish introduced livestock, and today the economy demands much more of the ranching than farming. Today, the Zia Pueblo is called home to about 650 people who continue to practice agriculture and raise livestock. They also make pottery and often display the sun symbol or a bird motif. They continue to speak the Karazin language, and many also speak Navajo, Spanish, and English. We hope you enjoy the tribal sounds of Zia, the Sacred Four, by William Owens.
Thank you.
decides to continue in band at the university they decide to go to next. We know that being in band at ICC was a choice, and we are thankful that these students chose to create music with us during their time at ICC. Will all the Symphonic Band sophomores please stand? From the entire band staff, we say thank you.